Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with
you.
Good morning. As we gather together, prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Let us call to mind our Savior. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my misdeeds, Lord. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Tearing each other to pieces, You had better watch or you will destroy the whole community. Let me put it like this. If you are guided by the Spirit, you will be in no danger of yielding to self-indulgence, since self-indulgence is the opposite of the Spirit. The Spirit is totally against such a thing, and it is precisely because the two are so opposed that you do not always carry out your good intentions. If you are led by the Spirit, no law can touch you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To get back to Mallorca.
seems to be a common phrase that people use when they're away. And people use this phrase such as "Home Sweet Home." There's no place like home, as Dorothy said as she kicked her heels three times on her way back to Kansas in the Wizard of Oz. Home is a very important place. It's often the place where we find security, where we find peace, where we find rest and relaxation. We surround ourselves with things that give us comfort to help us in the midst of our lives. There's nothing strange in that. However, sometimes we know that people are desperate to get away from home. We can think about the desires of a young person who maybe feels that the confines of home are restrictive and the rules and regulations that are laid down by their parents is not allowing them to express themselves fully, and they think to themselves, I can't wait to get away from this place. Maybe it's a university or another higher place of education, or maybe a different place. And so in that sense, the sense of escape is always there. I also remember that some people were very reluctant to go away from their home. My grandmother, who was notoriously reluctant to go away, would use phrases like, somebody's got to look after the dog. You haven't got a dog, Grandma, we used to say. She said, it doesn't matter, it's the point that matters. I often wonder what Jesus' home was like in Nazareth. We know very little about it in some ways. We don't hear very much of what's called the hidden years. Those that time between his birth and Bethlehem, his parents' flight into Egypt, his presentation in the temple, and other such stories. But then there is nothing, nothing until he leaves home and he begins his public ministry, which we think was probably at the age of 30. In today's Gospel from Luke, we hear a turning point in Jesus' life. As the time drew near for him to be taken up to heaven, Jesus resolutely took the road from Jerusalem. This would be the final turning point in Jesus' life, as he would begin to leave the confines and security of Galilee, the area in which he was brought up, to go to Jerusalem in the south, where ultimately what would welcome him would be the cross, his death, and his resurrection. In that sense, it was an enormous challenge for Jesus to leave that security of home and to take that road to Jerusalem. And initially, he meets resistance. He sends disciples ahead of him to a Samaritan town, but they would not accept him because he was heading to Jerusalem. Jerusalem was an anathema to the Samaritans. It was a heresy because they believed that they were following another tradition of Judaism, which had no place in the temple in Jerusalem. And so they would not accept him. We also see this. There's a very strange pastoral plan formed by James and John. That pastoral plan is, shall we send down fire from heaven and burn them up? Of course not, says Jesus, and he rebuked them. He then meets three people who have a desire to follow him. But Jesus says to the first, follow me won't be easy. We have no place to rest our heads. We must turn away from all comforts, because to proclaim the good news demands total focus and total commitment. Another one says, just go and bury my father. And Jesus firmly says, leave the dead to bury the dead. The third one says, let me go home to say goodbye to my parents. No, Jesus says, anyone who looks back is not fit for the kingdom of God. These are strong words. But I think St. Luke is trying to tell us through his interpretation of these events in the life of Jesus that those who follow the way of the gospel are called to be totally committed to that. And that will demand in itself certain sacrifices, certain securities that we surround ourselves to be let go. There is indeed a challenge to be a disciple. But I'm sure that Jesus wouldn't mind if we committed ourselves to the good news, that we went home and slept on our own bed.
We stand and confess.
Amen.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, conscious as of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for us salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified with the Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life.
Gathered here today in faith, we bring before God our prayers and petitions for our world, our community, and ourselves.
For all members of the Church, that we will hear and respond faithfully and courageously to the call of Christ to love our neighbour as ourselves.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all elected to public office, that they may foster an attitude of respect and care in society, seeking to heal divisions and always work for the common good of all people.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all throughout the world who are suffering as a result of war, conflicts and natural disasters, that the outreach of others will provide the practical support needed to live life free from fear.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all whose lives are impacted by any form of illness, that they may receive the care, compassion, and understanding they need to live their lives in peace and hope.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We bring before God those who have died, those whose anniversaries occur at this time, and those who mourn.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the parish of English martyrs charred with Crooker and Ilminster, and our own parish, that both as communities and individuals, we will be ready always to respond to the call of Christ in our lives.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask Mary, Mother of Christ, to pray with us and for us as we say,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
In the silence of our hearts, we turn to our Father with our personal intentions.
Heavenly Father, hear the prayers we make this day, those spoken and those made in the silence of our hearts. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise of the glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church.
O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ,
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Which is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world, that in your mercy you sent us, the Redeemer, to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours, that by sinning we have lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, of all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in all exaltation we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of." Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Aidan and Hildegard, to whom we offer this Mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but let me say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.